there are so many professionals working publicly in mental health, particularly in Limerick, that I would know of, that are working to the bone every day to try and help the mental health of young people. I think sometimes that doesn't get seen because it gets hidden behind waiting lists and lack of resources and that kind of thing.
The Limerick Post speaks to Dr. Kian Ahern, clinical psychologist and clinical coordinator with Jigsaw Limerick, about the facilities and services on offer for young people in Limerick, the CAMHS controversy, and what we can do as a community and as a country to raise awareness around mental health and educate and support our young people.
Our service is set up to help people who are looking for help and who are looking for support. So the young people who tend to come to Jigsaw Limerick are people who are looking for a space for support and to talk. In terms of being out there in the community and other services and facilities, there are quite a large number of services and groups and clubs throughout Limerick that are there to avail of if we can find ways for young people to engage with them. Like I said, we work closely with the Limerick Youth Service as well, who offer a wide range of activities and clubs with a view to helping young people all the time. So they are there. Sometimes it's trying to find ways that will motivate and help young people to engage with them.
Ireland has progressed a lot as a country, but there still seems to be an association with mental health and weakness. Is there still stigma around mental health in this country?
And that's a massive piece of what we do, to be honest, is breaking that down. And we do feel that, I know you can see the statistics of a lot more people attending maybe mental health services or talking about their difficulties, but we see that as probably a positive in that people are actually talking about things now and that they're going to the right places for support. One of the major things that we try to promote is help seeking, so looking for help when you're feeling vulnerable and going to that one good adult when times are difficult, and we've seen that that's a really protective factor. And again, it's that whole kind of early intervention ethos, is that when something is bothering you, it's rather than let it build up over time and become more kind of complicated and difficult, go seek support initially, go seek it when you're feeling distressed initially and kind of tackle it when it's more manageable.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the real ethos of Jigsaw, is getting there early, and that's why it's the 12 to 25, is because we know that long term people's difficulties can get more complex and severe if not tackled during that kind of adolescent period, and that's when the majority of people with kind of chronic and severe difficulties later in life first identified experiencing those difficulties.
What can we do as a community to get behind and support Jigsaw?
It's absolutely amazing how generous and thoughtful people have been. Like, we've had a number of donations without ever asking or seeking them in Limerick. And in the last week even, Emma Langford, a local singer-songwriter, like, raised money off a single to donate any profits to Jigsaw, which was just wonderful.
What can you expect when you walk through the doors of Jigsaw?
We try our best to have a really youth-friendly environment. As you can see, like, this is one of the therapeutic rooms here where young people would have picked out the colours and picked out the furniture. And that goes from the moment you step in the door to straight through to whatever number of sessions you might attend. There's a real emphasis on it being youth-centred, young person-centred and focused, and to really, we try to really bring a compassionate space where people can have space to talk about and go through the kind of distressing experiences that they might be having. The reason, I guess, that the furniture and the place is as youth-friendly as it is we have a youth advisory panel, so that's like a panel of 10 to 20 young people who are interested in mental health in Limerick, so they're aged between 16 and 25, and we meet with them on a regular basis to help inform all that we do, and each hub around the country would have a panel, and there's a national panel as well, and we just feel that that's really important and a really good model to work from, in that any services that we're providing is being informed by the kinds of people who are attending.
Jigsaw provides support to those aged from 12 to 25, but where do younger children find support?
And those presentations can be quite different to what we deal with, but there are, again, a number of services in Limerick who support that age group, from ISPCC, to CAMHS, Community Psychology, and there's only just been a primary care mental health service open on Bark Street, I think, where parent support for young people across the age span is there as well.
Should we be concentrating more on bringing mindfulness and mental health awareness into primary schools?
At times we do offer workshops to sixth class, you know, where it's a kind of a transition piece from sixth class to secondary schools. And there, I know there are a number of programs already in place in primary schools as well. I know there's a massive mindfulness project taking place in Corpus Christi there in Moy Ross at present. So we really just need to focus on, you know, the bits that we're good at and that we know work for that 12 to 25 piece.
There has been a lot of controversy of late surrounding the Child and Mental Health Services, CAM, and the long waiting list for children to be seen by consultants. What can we do as a country to help deal with this crisis?
CAMHS would provide a service that's a bit more long term, that does have medical supports, and again, maybe there's more severe presentations there as well. So it is an entirely different service. Unfortunately, those wait times are there. I don't know, like, they're there for a reason. I don't think that there's an alternative space that's going to kind of fill that gap at the moment. That's the whole reason for focusing on early intervention, is that you get less people needing to access the more specific services when their needs are being met earlier on. Because it's when it gets to the point of being more complex and severe, that's when you need a specialised service. Whereas if we can kind of encourage each other to promote help seeking and supporting people in distress from a young age or from an earlier standpoint, then those difficulties don't become as severe, and specialised services aren't being put under as much pressure then. There are so many professionals working publicly in mental health, particularly in Limerick, that I would know of, that are working to the bone every day to try and help the mental health of young people. I think sometimes that doesn't get seen because it gets hidden behind waiting lists and lack of resources and that kind of thing. But really, the vast majority of professionals in Limerick in particular are doing their very best to meet the demand, the high demand that's there. Recruitment is really difficult. We see that in Jigsaw as well, that it's the recruitment of professionals is the bit that maybe just needs a bit more concentration. We started with our full complement of 7 last year, and in August, one person had to leave due to personal reasons, but it took us a full 5 months to get someone to fill the post. That's a major kind of emphasis across the organisation, is that the people we get in are really meeting the kind of ethos and message of Jigsaw and what we do. If we can kind of shift the needle on how many people are requiring maybe early intervention or getting their needs met early on, then on a societal level we're going to see less of the kind of more severe presentations anyway. So really, that early intervention prevention message is what needs to get out there, you know, encouraging help seeking, looking towards one good adult, and again, just being there and listening to people when they're distressed. They're the kind of skills we need as a society, and they're the bits that can be lacking at times.